Approximately 1 year ago on this date, the unthinkable happened at a little-known island volcano within the nation of Tonga. A slightly more than 2-mile-wide island exploded in the largest explosive volcanic eruption of the 21st century, an eruption which was likely, at a minimum, a little more than 7.5 times larger than the highly destructive 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. Whereas beforehand, the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano had 2 interconnected islands on the northern rim of a large, primarily submarine volcano. In the aftermath, this island had not only split in two, but the center of the volcano lost 750 meters, or 2,460 feet in height, as a several kilometer wide section of it collapsed into a caldera. Before the eruption, the 2 previously separated islands were lush, green, and densely forested. And now, with footage courtesy of Taaniela Kula, Pupunu Tukuafu, and Shane Cronin, I can show you what remains of the once highly beautiful Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai complex above sea level. All of the trees, vegetation, moss, lichens, and any animals which live there were completely annihilated. However, not all was lost, as the sheer cliffs and scarred landscape left by the destructive eruption are already being visited by and have become the nesting sites of numerous seabirds. This video serves to showcase the before and after of the now largely destroyed island, as the eruption was a testament to the destructive power nature can bring. First, some background information. The reason for the unusual name of this volcano, which some find hard to pronounce, relates to what used to be 2 forested and separate islands. To the east-northeast was the island of Hunga Tonga, while to the west-southwest was the island of Hunga Ha'apai. After it was discovered that these 2 separate islands both owed their existence to the same volcano, the complex received its name of Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai via combining the names of those 2 islands. When the catastrophic Plinian eruption occurred on January 15th of 2022, the explosive force of the 1 or more blasts had an energy equivalent of perhaps as much as the detonation of 18 megatons of TNT. This blast and the later caldera collapse destroyed large swaths of the 2 original islands. Now shown is all the remains of the southwestern Hunga Ha'apai Island. The blast separated this island into 2 portions with volcanic layers that formed the island now exposed for all to see. If you are wondering why the island appears tilted down away from the camera, this is due to uneven subsidence related to the caldera collapse which occurred during 2022. You might be wondering why the island now has 3 distinct colors, light brown, black, and red. The answer is each of these colors represents a distinct type of volcanic deposit which originally formed the island. The brown represents primarily ash deposits produced via either shallow submarine eruptions or eruptions just barely above sea level, representing island-forming Sertsayan-style eruptions. On the other hand, the red represents scoria. It formed through Strombolian-style eruptions which intermittently ejected ash and bombs of lava like commonly seen at the Mount Etna volcano in Italy. And the black represents an effusive portion of an eruption as it marks lava deposits which have a gray to black coloration due to their basalt to andesite composition. The reason the islands seemingly cleaved in a way where mostly scoria and lava rock were exposed relates to them being much harder than simple ash deposits. Now, here are the remnants of the original Hunga Tonga Island. The apparent pinnacle-like structure at its summit represents the remains of a thick lava deposit, likely at one point representing a location of a source vent where supplied molten rock erupted. The light blue hues in the water you are seeing represent particulates in the ocean which could be caused by erosion of the Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai edifice above or below sea level, submarine fumaroles venting gases, or a combination of both. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.